Hello there, my name is Mr. Smartonkey. Welcome back to my Let's Play of Shogun 2, the Otomo clan on Legendary Difficulty. So last time we left off, we took Higo, Hizen, and Tsukushi in the first two turns, which was pretty good. We're now going to probably just sit here for quite a while, having these provinces become a little bit more Christian, and also we'll probably be moving some units that take Satsuma and maybe take out the Ito as well while we're at it, so we got the entire island for ourselves. Which will then allow us to make lots of money for a while. So this boat's still going to go there, as it was planning on doing last time. And we just made a second boat, which is going to go towards this one. And then the third one is going to go up and probably go take either this one or maybe over to the, towards that one first. We'll see how we do what we do there. Let's first get these units into Higo. We've got a lot of unhappiness, so we're probably either going to have to face some rebellions or exempt places from taxes, but it's so much money that I would be exempting, so I'm not really too fond of doing any of that. So also, something I haven't really discussed yet is provinces that are going to make me money in the future, and Tsukushi and Hizen are two amazing provinces. They have very fertile soil and very fertile soil. We also have a port here, which is also good for town growth, and this thing, which gives us a trade income or experience for ships, but I'll probably go for the trade. Actually, I'm not sure. I will be making most of my ships in Bizen, so not sure. Anyway, and we also have this thing, which will allow us to make a better meds case right away. I might upgrade that right off the bat, and then make a market here, and that will then allow us to make a level 3 meds case this early on, which is crazy, because it will obviously give us crazy income right off the bat. So I'm not sure if I'm going to keep that. I might change it in a second. I have to look around with happiness and such. We have one unit here who can go towards Tsukushi. He's not going to actually reach, but we also have our missionary. So we have three provinces that actually are on the verge of going rebellion. Going rebellion, yeah, that's the best English I've ever heard. One of them is Tsukushi right here. One of them is Hizen, which is only up to -4, and one of them is Higo, which is also -4. I think we might let this one rebel, because we can deal with that. We've got enough men here, we've got a gun unit, we've got two Yari Ashigaru. That should be enough, should suffice. We also have four units here, which I'm gonna send that way. We can only let two of them go, but I should be making more units here anyway. Although I kind of want to start making some matchlock Ashigaru, although they are a lot of upkeep in comparison, so I might not until a bit later on. I don't really want to send two, because then if a rebellion appears around there, I don't know if I can defend against it. I'm actually not sure if I want to send anything in that case, because if I send all four, then even then, I don't know how big the rebellion's going to be. So we'll hold off on that for now. We also, have we looked at our plot? Yeah, there's nothing changed there. So -4 here, this is another one that I can let rebel because we have an army here, so that's not too bad. And the rebellion is actually a good thing in the end because it's going to help us out. This one is a bit more problematic because it's only a fort. It's -7, so even doing this wouldn't fix it. I could put the missionary in there, which will make it -5, I believe, which is still not going to fix it. -6, actually, so he only gets one happiness. That is too much, because we're going to stay on that next turn. This is going to go up culture, and I know the mastery arts. I don't know what the culture one is. But either way, 6, this unit can't even get in there, so that's not going to help at all. Plus the town is unhappy now because that guy left, which is weird, because this one was +1, wasn't it? So how did it just go down from that guy leaving? It only went up here by 1, but it went down by 2 in Bizen. That doesn't really seem to make any sense. But that's fine. This province is fine. I think we'll move this guy over here. Because if this place does rebel, doing this isn't going to help it. And then making a unit, it's also not going to help it. And we can't make 2 units a turn here, so I think that's not going to do it. Unless that culture pops in, but I don't know what that actually means. The market's not going to make any happiness. Oh, right, the magistrate. But that's only 3 turns away from now, so yep, that's not going to happen either. So I'm not going to make that unit either, I don't think. This is definitely a little more problematic. Um, If we make a unit here, it means I could move a unit out of here. If I move a unit into Kushi, because this place, actually no, it doesn't really matter at all, does it? Well, unless I actually also do this, that's what I'm more talking about. This is the downside of taking so many provinces so quickly, obviously. I don't really want to stop exempting. I think we can deal with the rebellions. This one and this one I'm pretty much guaranteed to be able to deal with because we have to go a unit in there. This one is a little bit more difficult because we only have these two units and the fort. But there's nothing I can do about it either way. We can't fix that or anything. This is definitely a good idea. On the other hand, obviously roads and such are also really useful, and the farms. But I think for now we'll stick with that. That's really good. So yeah, four units here. If we're gonna let that rebel, I think I'll move them over anyway. Actually, hold on. Can we move into the forest or anything? None of that is actually being hidden. Well, in that case, I guess we'll leave those units there. They're not gonna make a difference. Well, I do need to get them over there. This is so annoying. But the thing is, I don't want to get this town unhappy either. Although next turn, I guess I could make two units and that would fix it. This isn't going down anymore, or up anymore either. It's actually going to go down soonish. Alright, well, let's just send over the four units. They can get there in two turns. Alright. So yeah, working on Zen, so that's going to help out a lot. Every town is currently unhappy. Since everyone's going to rebel anyway, I may as well do this. Just for a turn, get that ridiculous income. Let's see what, minus 27, minus 40. It's already, that's a lot though, why is it so much? Utter. Factor, discontent, right, okay, so because of happiness reasons. You know what, I'll do this for a turn. We can use the little bit of extra income, and then we'll just reduce it again next turn. So we should make a unit. I was making a unit, I believe. I queue one up here. Is that the blood space for a unit? I think it is. Because they can reach anywhere. I'll send over this gun unit there. The bow unit here will suffice. That will make this a lot better defense. Let's hope the rebellions aren't too big. But yeah, the unit here is fine because it can move there in one turn, and if I make it here and we actually lose this town, then that would be more problematic. Good thing about this is as well, having rebellions here, is these guys get to fight, which means that I might develop another general out of the blue. Although that guy's 15, so he's going to be coming of age soon as well. My daimyo is 43, this guy's 26, that's pretty good. Oh yeah, I completely forgot to change him to developer, or development, which is actually what I needed to do to make this town less happy. Or actually, no, both of these towns less unhappy. So I think that's where I kind of made a mistake. Although it probably would have only been one happiness, maybe two, because he is ranked 2. Oh well. Let's go for Commissioner for Finance, I think, either way. I guess, actually, let's go for development anyway. And we're going to cancel these buildings and remake them. It's going to be slightly cheaper. Boom, look at that. And now, actually, can we make another unit? Oh, just off. Anyway, right, so let's see if we die or not. I'm quite confident about most of them. But not all. And of course, we do have the Shimazu coming up as well. But I'm pretty sure we'll be able to deal with that. Rebellion. Rebellion. Mounting unrest. Mounting unrest and rebellion. Right. Ooh. That's a fairly significant army. So is that one. And so is that one. Well, first of all, let's change that down. So Buzen is at minus 1. Alright, well, making a unit here will fix that. Both samurai. It's pretty good. I think we're just going to spam out units right now everywhere. This place is 2, I assume. Yep. Minus 2, I mean. These guys are not going to be able to get inside, which is a problem. If I move them there, they will be in reinforcement range of the town. Alright, it's probably the best bet I've got. Ship builds, right, all that, that's all good. We need to make units, that's for sure. I probably should have made units last turn. Instead of making those two buildings. But hey, what are you gonna do? Right. I guess since we have a... This guy is not going to be able to reach here for like 3 turns, so this town should be alright, which actually means I might send over some extra units to here. You can get inside. That's 4 units. Send over this guy as well. I don't think that guy is going to be able to reach here. At least one... Or at least not until the next turn. Actually, in that case, I may as well send over more units. Yeah, I think I will. Not sending over the general. Although then again, why not? Because I kind of want to get experience. I might want to get an extra general. That's probably the main reason. Okay, anyway. Ships. Let's get to the more fun parts. Which is making money. Let's hope there's no one on there yet. Nope. Good. Let's get over there, and this one is gonna go around the other way. Alright. So we're making a unit there, we're making a unit there, we're making a unit there, we're making 2 units there, and we're making no units here. Let's make some units. Yari Ashigaru are just way better than Bo Ashigaru. That's why I'm making them, although I do feel like I maybe should make some... Some Matchlock Ashigaru. They are really good, but they're also extreme upkeep, and I don't really want to pay that up kind of upkeep right now. Okay, we need to get roads going. I guess from here is pretty good. And we also need to get that going, but I think roads is more important right now. Let's get roads in Tsukushi, since it actually goes all the way down here, which is useful reinforcing Higo. Plus, this is one of my money-making provinces as well, so the roads early on is good. Although these roads don't actually do anything for money, but the next ones do. Okay, so this is kind of annoying, because these guys didn't reach inside, but they are in reinforcement range. However, I would like... I don't know what I would like. If I would like these guys to get attacked or the actual town, I'm not sure. This is fine, or it should be. This is probably fine. Against this army. The rebels, of course, have very little morale. Although these guys, yeah, they are shoni, but I think they're still count as rebels, so they should also have terrible morale, even though they do have a general. And that one, too. Oh, well, they all do, actually. This town is going to be fine. So, yeah, I think there's not really anything else we can do. Didn't get to make any more units, except for that one, which before these guys will be able to reach. They won't be going for Eisen. Okay, then I guess that's all. And this guy's coming in, but if we can deal with this, then I'm sure we can deal with that too. But we'll see. He didn't actually move, so he's probably waiting for reinforcements. So he's probably going to be attacking with a larger army. All right, there's the first attack. So, 6 archers, 8 Yari Ashigaru, and a general. Apparently, he has free experience as well. Doesn't really matter, but... Should be fine. Our gunmen are going to do most of the heavy lifting. For some reason, my voice keeps cracking up again. I don't know what's going on. Whenever I record Shogun 2, my voice cracks up. I don't know. It's something to do with this game, apparently. Anyway, so yeah, 3, or at least for now, 2 tough fights to... deal with, but if anything, it's gonna give us some good experience if we can have most of our men survive. The biggest problem we're gonna have with these fights is the archers. The amount of archers they have is problematic, but it should be fine. We may actually be able to set up in to sit down. That's annoying. There's a really good formation for this. I'm sure you've seen it in my previous campaigns, especially the Hattori one. I think I use it a few times in We have really good formation. However, it means that my guns don't really... I don't really get to use my guns all that much. And obviously, guns are the most important unit right now. So I do need to use my guns, which means that that formation is either not going to work, or I will only use it a little bit. Right. So yeah, I'm going to put my guns here. Like so. The formation is basically... I've shown it before, but just a quick... And then you put these three units in your eyeball. It's obviously, it's a bit fucked up right now, but that's the general gist of it. Right, Archer, that's you. Let's put you on the other side. They might come from that side as well. And the rest is melee. This guy's my general, my most hurt unit. That's great. We actually do have enough units to make that tactic work. But again, the problem is my guns wouldn't be really useful. But I might do it anyway. I will set the units up in that formation. Actually, no. No, I don't think I will. What I'll do is I'll set them up back here. Oh, we actually don't have enough. Well, yeah, we do have enough units. It's not perfect, but yeah. And this guy. Right. That's yadi yadi. Yadi yadi yadi. Yadi yadi yadi. That must mean he's got all of his bows on one side. Bow, 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 bow. Alright, so we've got one bow unit facing six. That's perfect. If you didn't understand, that was sarcasm. Sarcasm even. Sarcasm! However... We should be able to deal with his Yaris fairly easily. I'm actually gonna keep you... Keep you out of the fight for the beginning. Should be able to deal with his men fairly easily. Maybe I should even not fight these archers, but I think I'll just sacrifice that archer unit. I want to get at least two volleys, possibly three volleys off. I wonder if we can shatter that unit before it even reaches me. Oh my god, gun units are so awesome. I'm not going to try one more volley. I'm going to take them off. I don't want to lose a single man of these guys. They're too important to lose. But I will... put you right there and you might be able to kill a few men. Alright, so this is all going to be terribly easy. Oh, that's actually not a great formation. Let's see if we can readjust that a little bit before we get absolutely slaughtered from the side. Doesn't look like it. Let's see if we can adjust this unit a little bit. Or they just don't listen at all. Where's my gap filler? There you are. Okay. Oh shit, these guys are climbing the walls over here. Let's have them shoot a few men and then get them off the wall again. Still hear gunfire, so they're actually not climbing there anymore. I still don't really want to get them all shot up, so. Okay, that's broken. Let's have you guys. Let's stick them up. I'll keep them on there. They're not really losing too many men just yet. What the hell are you doing? Okay, you're getting out of formation, you're going in there, because apparently you don't know how to listen. General. Or captain. What are these guys doing? Okay, you got a Vyari wall. Readjust a little bit. Got a packing Yari wall. You guys get out of Yari wall. Stay out of Yari wall. Get over here.
Our general is in grave danger, really? My lord.
General, get over here. Okay, so guns. Alright, we have lost some gunmen now. We still have to deal with most of the archers, but once we've killed all these men, have you guys get in there. And you kill off these men. Actually, you should probably block the gate so that they don't all leave. What are you doing? Okay, that's fine, whatever. We're going to actually fire a bit more on this unit and then see if we can shatter it. And then we're going to move this unit away from here. His general should be coming up pretty soon as well. Alright, there's a Yari Ashigaru unit. What are you doing? Get away from there. Alright. How about you make that unit run? Oh wow, we actually shuttered that one as well. Okay. Since they're not aiming at these guys, we're going to take these guys. Kill off these men, please. Before they get away. Kill off all those stranglers. Alright, that's a broken unit. Are you out of ammo or something? You are as well. Alright, well. In that case, no need to lose any more of you. Get you over there. What? How did I just target someone? Yeah, whatever. Just get over there. Alright, general has arrived. You two, get out of formation. Get sort of over here-ish. Go on, murder these men. No, that's a unit that's already gone. We may as well shoot the units that are still alive. Although these guys are going to get slaughtered by these arrows now, so we need to... Pretty sure I told you to attack that unit. I want to get them off here. What the fuck are you doing? Oh wow, how many units have they still got? A lot. Okay, just get over there. Not you. Okay, just the two of you is fine. And Yari wall. Right. That's a bow unit climbing the walls. Alright, you guys have done enough. Let's get you off there. You two. Hang back around here, will you? Okay. This is the final push. We killed this general. There's a good chance that the archers will run. But not necessarily. Okay, these guys are sort of a lightning destructor or whatever. Wait, hold on. No, that's not what I wanted at all. What the hell is this unit? General, charge in there. You guys stay out of here. I need these archers to climb the walls, but I'm pretty sure they still have range over here. Okay, in that case, shoot these men as they run away. Alright, you charge. That's a bow unit. Really shouldn't charge that unit. Alright, you broke them. Charge them. You, kill some of these men, if you will. You still have plenty of ammo. Really should use it. I meant you to charge in there. Didn't really end up doing that, but I still want you to. I haven't lost any Yari yet, to be honest. The one thing I'm a little bit worried about is losing too many of these guys. It's really the only thing I'm worried about. Okay, let's not... Let's make sure we don't lose any more. Actually, yeah, let's put you on the wall there. You can kill some of those men. I really need these archers to start climbing the walls, though. That would be immense. Let's get everyone over here so that they might not be in range. And they will either start climbing or walking around. I think these guys will start climbing soon, now. And these guys might be able to get a few more kills. They have 278 so far. Alright, so their general is running. They are still firing at me, or at least this one unit is. They are running around.
The general has fallen. A cutting blow.
Great. Okay. Yari wall, dudes. Get out of Yari wall. And get over here. Don't go outside the walls, if you can. Avoid it. Alright, there's one unit. Let's have you guys go over here. And then we'll have you follow up. And... Oh, they just ran. These guys were all... They ran as well.
My lord,
there we go.
A glorious victory will soon be yours.
See, that's what I mean. It should be fairly doable to defeat all these armies. I'm going to put these guys on because these are all running back here. So I'm going to put them on the wall right there. I might be able to kill a fair amount of men. If I can get them there quickly. Because there is a lot of... target practice. Sadly, my archers ran out of arrows really quickly. Their ammo of 20, so they must have fired 20 volleys. The quickest they could ever have volleyed. Come on, get on there quick. There's so many so much target practice for you, so much experience. You're gonna lose it, or you're gonna lose a lot of experience because you're recruiting a lot of new men. So I need you to get this experience for me. All right, still a lot to kill though. Go on. I know there's a button to watch, but I can't remember what button it is, so it's too bad. But at least we get to see it from here. It's a pretty terrible sight. I'm just getting picked off. I mean, we're not getting a lot of kills, but oh, we got a fair amount already. Not sure if they're going to be able to shoot anyone else there. They don't seem to be shooting over there. There's such a lot of shooting on the bridge there. There's such a massive blob. They're all stuck around there. Guess we'll try and move them over there. See if that works a little bit better. These guys might start shooting. There's such a big blob. Any shot in there is a guaranteed kill. Can't wait to get Dunderboss Cavalry. You move a Dunderboss Cavalry around here, they kill this entire blob of enemies with one shot. It's crazy. These guys are OP as hell. Or one volley, I should say. I don't think they're shooting over there, sadly. Is that, like, out of... Oh, it should be possible. I think I actually just saw someone getting shot over there. Oh yeah, there's some kills here. I honestly should have just moved them outside and just have them stand here and have them shoot. I think it's just too late now, otherwise I probably would have done it. I'll do it anyway. Might be able to get over there. I really should have moved these guys outside as well. Fucking hell, why didn't I think of that? I could have had all of these kills if I moved these guys outside, because I knew they were going to run around there, so why not, you know? Fucking idiots. You guys as well. Might be able to get some men over there. Gun units. Oh yeah, they should be able to get a few more kills here. If they don't shoot my own men, that is. Which is probably not possible anymore. Oh, I guess we got a few more kills by running around here. Maybe. Yeah, look at that. It's all dead. And this guy. Aw. He got away. Anyway, that was a fine fight. Except the end. That was terrible. I could have killed at least like 300 more men or something. That was really stupid. But anyway, this will be fine. We'll replenish some men, we'll get some a new unit here as well, so if they come at me again, then it should be a lot easier either way. Their general is also dead, so overall, it's fine. Although, it sort of depends, since we do have to move some units over to the other town. I don't know if we can actually get through. Nope, they're standing in the way. Alright, this is the one I was a little bit worried about. These four our units are reinforcements. However, half his army is light cav and the general, so that's actually not too bad. Only two archers, so this is perfect. These two units are going to win me the fight. They sure will. Those two units and the four units outside. The Yaris are going to win this fight. Oh, and this is the best castle as well. Great. Let's hope he doesn't go for rain or something. But that usually isn't likely in winter. At least when I try to go for rain, it never gives me it. It's always stupid fog and shit like that. Probably should have had a look at the kills that we got just now as well on the gun unit. Although I think it was like 320 or 30 or something. I don't know how many kills we got after when I checked, but not a ridiculous amount. I remember when I first... Actually, no, well, yeah, when I did a co-op with Ptolemy, and I was playing as the Otomo, I had a unit that got like 1,200 kills or something in a fight. It's crazy. Anyway, you're gonna go over here. Our reinforcements are sadly coming from this side. That is the opposite of where I want them to come from. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from? But Nigel. Look at that. Tactics. We actually have a general here, my daimyo. Out of all generals. Right, and these two are going to win me the fight, like I said. I will set them up like this right away, because I know this is the formation I will be using. It has to be perfect, or it could lose me the fight. Not even joking. Only 116 of these, or 60 in these even. Alright, and then this unit, this unit, thingy. Gonna go right there. It's not a Yar unit, of course, but it'll do the job. Okay, nothing from there. Ah, so his entire army is coming from there. That is fine. It's kind of annoying, actually. Well, I mean, it's fine, but it's annoying because I wouldn't want his cavalry to come and attack me. And I can't run my guys over there. He had like 7 cav units though, right? So they must be either in the forest or coming from somewhere else. Ah, here we go. There's a few more. Oh, there's just 2 bow units and his light cav. Right, well, in that case, I'm gonna move this bow unit over here. Since there's nothing melee coming this way. So he had like 7 cav, right? There's 3 of them there. 3 of them there. Maybe it was 6 and the general. Oh wait, that's a lot. Yeah, that's the general. Right, so there's... I think that's it. There might be one random that I'm not spotting right now. The thing is, these guys have to kill all those cav off. Well, they don't have to. We can still do it without it, but it would be useful. So I'm gonna... Yeah, I'm still walking them over there. Right. This is kind of annoying since the archers are coming from there, but we have an archer over there. Can you run over there, please? So that's going to be fine. This unit's going to be doing the first few volleys, and then it's going to not do anything anymore. We just want their archers not to shoot my melee men, because I only have 3, and that's the biggest deal. All right. First couple of volleys is all on you. Or all on you. I think afterwards I'll move them over here. See if I can get another quick volley in. Then move them around here and then back in there. And then these guys will go into Yari wall. Don't want to do it yet because it actually tires them out. Not a whole lot. Also going to inspire these fellas. Once the get in range. Can inspire the bow unit, but I think this is more important. I spread it out a little bit too far this way, but it's too late to change it now. Alright, let's get the killing, eh? Ah, here we go. I'll just tell them to charge, actually, to spread them out a little bit more, and then tell them to charge.
Our general is in grave danger, my lord.
I'm sure he's fine. Alright, how many kills have we got so far? 110. Pretty good. Could be more. Let's see if we can get another volley off or so. Gonna run him over here, actually, otherwise I'll never get another volley off of them. Boom, I actually managed to put him in Yari wall. Just in time. At least some of them I know. I guess. Oh. Might be able to get another volley off of them. I'm gonna put these guys in Yari wall in case I forget. That would be terrible. What are you doing? Oh shit, general. Forgot about you. Sorry. Oop. Mess up this formation a little bit. General, get in here. Or at least get behind these guys. Alright, you have to get in Yari wall. You dismount. Okay, this is gonna get screwed up a little bit. Oh, and these guys are fucked as well. I didn't think about that. No, don't get into a fight with these guys. You cannot win that fight. Don't bother. Alright, you've killed all those men. Let's get you over here. Now, get your ass in here, somehow. You, got out of formation to kill those men off. Alright, we have done it. This is not a perfect formation anymore, though. Oh, general. Let's not have you initiate the first fights. It's exactly the opposite of what I want. Oh, they're already broken. That's great. So we killed 3 archers so far. We're defending our archer unit, so he's still firing on them. He hasn't even lost that much yet. So we are looking pretty good. I need to... Wait, General, are you in there again? Are you mental? Get out of there. There's a few of them in there, but I don't know if it's the actual general in there. That would be terrible. One of them just died. It wasn't the general, but still. Need to make sure that doesn't happen. Okay, are you done here? Let's get you in formation again. Alright. These guys are going to get tired as fuck by the time they get here, but they've done their job, mostly. There's still a lot of cavalo. Since all of their Yaris just got taken out, or most of them anyway, I think he's actually running up to this mount, which is kind of annoying. It's the one thing I don't want. It's not the end of the world, but it would be easier if he just came charging at me. Although he might dismount and then come at me anyway. I've seen that before too. Okay, so how many kills have you guys got? 105, 16. Surprisingly little amount so far. You guys can all actually get in formation, a normal formation. Get your asses charged in there. Could do some flanking, but by the time we get it there, he's already dead. Okay, so yeah, there's all his units. Some of them coming back, and all of these light cav and such, which we didn't obviously get to take care of before. I might take this unit out of formation. I think I will, actually. Ooh, a gun unit. We have a gun unit. Oh yeah, of course, he's standing in there. Right, let's have you get over here. If I can protect him, then that's good. Right, where's that unit gone? Oh, frick. Did you go through that? No, don't. Get over here. Leave these guys in their formation. Don't screw their formation up for me. Okay, you're all done. Sure, kill that light cav unit right there. You shoot my own men in the back. Do whatever you think is right. Oh, and they're actually keeping everyone busy now. That's fine. They can. I'll move these guys up a little bit, but the Yari samurai or summer retainers, obviously, is none of my concern. Still need these guys to do some killing, though. They are doing some killing, but I want more killing. Alright, you're killing this light cap? Wait, where did that light cap go? Did we already kill it? Guess we probably did. Well, these four units are tired as hell, but they can kill a lot of men that are going to run away from this fight. These guys are going amazing as well right now. Go on, kill those men that are running away. Oh, I think we just did it.
My lord!
My lord!
Victory will soon be yours!
Will you do some killing, please? Just kill this general or something. Oh, they're all reloading. Let's get you on the wall instead. And there's those four units. They might be able to get some... Oh, wait, I have a general. Mount. So used to not having a general from the last fight that I completely forgot. Man, this is a really interesting start of the campaign so far. They should be able to get a fair amount of kills as well. I don't think these guys are actually going to reach too much. Alright, we're getting some shots off. Where is the archer unit? Over there. Get on their horses! Become Yari Cav! Do what you've always dreamed of doing. Dreamt, even. Doing. Yeah, just... Alright. I want to make sure we kill our general. Should be in there somewhere. Is that him? No, that's a light cav. It's hard to tell. It's the guy without the balloon, but I mean, there's so many guys without balloons because there's also light cav units in there. So yeah, it's hard to tell. So hard to tell that I'm not going to be able to tell. Oh wow, these guys reached him, and they're tired as hell. These guys are mental. Where's my general? Oh, did he bug out again, or is he already passed? Oh, he went this way. That's kind of annoying. Just send him over there. He probably would have caught up if he didn't go that way. Are you getting anyone? Your killings? How many kills did you actually get? 242, holy shit. 59, 18, 25. So I guess this unit took the lead on those reinforcements and got free experience from it, so that's pretty good. General, right. There's a lot of men here still. Let's be ambitious. Run all the way up to the front while killing these fellas, I guess.
The men are fatigued, my lord, and some must rest.
Yeah, I'm sure they are fatigued and some must rest, but you gotta do what you gotta do. Oh my god, that's a lot of men stuck over here. Let's get over there. Should be able to kill most of that. Nope. Alright. Now, we're gonna leave all that go. Actually, no, let's get a quick charge in there. Send all those men into the sea. We have enough time to get into position. How about you take a swim? Oh, snap. Alright, kill all that off. Still gonna be a lot that gets away, just as like the last fight, but hey. You cannot have it all. Alright, that should cover most of the troops that are gonna run away. And they're all okay. Well, they've got a lot of kills. All together. Okay, so now we're just gonna be a sort of mowing machine. They are gonna get men that are gonna get through, but not too many. In the big picture. I'm wondering if I should have dismounted them, so they may have killed more. I don't feel like they're killing anything anymore right now. There's a lot of bodies in there though, so they definitely did kill a lot. They're up to 210. But they probably could have killed all this as well. Maybe if I dismounted them. Who knows? Anyway, let's triple speed it. I'm pretty sure it's about to end in a few seconds anyway. Maybe there's some unit somewhere in a land far, far away that's still not reached the border, but I have no idea where he is, so let's assume he did. Oh, wow, a rogue victory. That's pretty cool. Is that the second one? Or is it... I don't think we got a rogue victory last time. I mean, we talked about having a rogue victory, but we didn't. Because I need to get some... I don't like heroic victories too much. I don't like the little things that it leaves on the map. What do you call it? The little statues. Because it speeds up the process towards Realm Divide. Although Realm Divide with the Otomo isn't too big a deal. Because you've got this amazing starting position. So you can make so much money early on anyway. They have 308 men remaining. Great. We can actually just go ahead and chase them off. Alright, they're not going to reach. But they might reach next turn. Alright, trade gained. Morale. Mirror of Amaratsu, that's good. Sun is born, quartermaster report, and a ship built. Okay, so this is done. This is slightly less done. I might be able to chase them off and kill them, though, with these guys combined, because I don't know if they'll be able to reach this turn. They might do, and that means I would lose Heizen, and I don't want to lose Heizen. But we are basically out of the... we fixed it, basically. We're done. We're good. That's what I meant to say. Okay, there's that army. It is growing a little bit. Anyway, the good stuff first. Ships. Money makers. That's... could be something else, but I mean my ships that are making me money. Not titties. Right, you're gonna go over there. And that means, since it doesn't look like anyone's going to reach this, I'm going to send these guys up there to start claiming that one. If there's no one there yet. This one really... it's silk. That's like the best one, money-wise. You're going to also go over there. Actually, no, you're going to go to that one instead. Alright, right, there it is. I don't know how many more ships I've got queued up. One more. Let's queue up a few more. Actually, let's just queue up one for now, because I want to make sure I actually have the money to do whatever else I want to do as well. Right, so you're just going to finish this guy off. I need to send those units as well. They might not reach back into town if I do that. So, get in there now. There we go. We have two more units here, which I'm going to not keep, because I don't need to keep units anymore. Because, ah, there we go. See, that's what I wanted heroic victories for. Free honor. Great victories, plus one. And that's what we want. Right, so you guys can actually... this army is good enough to hold off most stuff. I really want to make some of these guys, but they're going to ruin my income, and I really need income right now for all the buildings that I still need to upgrade. This unit is also not needed here. And Zen is still being done as well, and also next turn we'll have the Magistrate, so Tsukushi should be pretty happy. Plus, we're going to get a lot of happiness from getting rid of all them. Of course, we still need to get more missionaries, but... Anyway, also, we need to get a gunsmith at some point here. Actually, yeah, what do we actually need to build those units? What else do we need to build those units? Nanman Trade, Nanman Quarter. And all the way at the bottom, the Portuguese Tacos. We need a... Right, a Powder Maker. So we do need to make a Powder Maker. And the Powder Maker will also allow us to build... Otomo Matsutaka Shigaru. Right. Powder Maker, that's the first building. Good. Although it does require... No, that's the second building. Siege Engineer's Workshop. But that's the funny thing. The Siege Engineer's Workshop is unlocked by getting Strategy of Attack. And then the Gunsmith or Powder Maker is unlocked by doing Attack on by Fire. So we need to get Strategy of Attack and then go for this. But the thing I am thinking about is the... Actually, I would make them here anyway. The Dunderbuss Cavalry. I have no idea. I guess that just goes through stables. Warhorse stables. Alright, that's fairly easy. Dunderbuss Cav. They also need a Powder Maker, of course. But yeah, that's fairly easy. Okay. Right. Then. Do I want to make more units? I don't think I really do. I do need to keep units here at some point. Actually, I could probably just keep a ship here. Because I'm a War of the Ouchie. So I can't leave this completely undefended. So I need to have an army here, and I need to have an army here against the Shimazu. Although I'll probably take these three provinces, but... Yeah. Have we met anyone yet? No. Would you actually take peace?
I have no. Better things to do than listen to an old woman's prattle. Speak and try to make sense!
I'm trying to make sense, sir. Okay, I don't want to... peace with you anyway. I'm gonna murder you. Okay, right. So, some roads here would probably be good for income, and that'll allow us to make a market as well. That doesn't allow us to make any units, but I think we'll be all right. So I do need to take care of this army. I'm going to move these units over here, and then I'm going to attack with this army, because then I might spawn another general, because it will be their second fight. I actually have to fight this. They have still have their six archers. I have one archer and my Matsutaka Shigaru, so I'm gonna have to just attack them out on. They have barely any infantry. I do need to fight it. Can't resolve that. I will lose too much. I might lose some entire units, maybe even my general, and I don't want that. Okay, they're gonna have a really good hill. We're just gonna have to charge up there and hope for the best, really. Can't do too many tactical things. I haven't even discussed my army setup yet on this campaign. It's going to consist of guns. I don't know exactly yet. Probably something like four Dunderbuss Cavalry. Because they're freaking crazy. They're really hard to use. They require a lot of micromanagement. But they're potentially ridiculous. Some Portuguese Turcos, probably six or eight, gonna be very heavy guns. Although I find guns extremely difficult to use in. Actually, I might go for fog if I can find it. All right, never mind then. Yeah, they're really hard to use guns. In my opinion, I find it hard to use in field battles anyway. On the siege defenses, they're amazing. Since you're actually quite badly hurt, we're going to leave you out of this. Because you need to sort of flank with them. Obviously, they're not like arrows. They can't shoot over your men, so you need to flank with them, which means that you have to leave them unprotected. The Portuguese Tarkas are pretty good units to protect themselves, though. They're quite good. But obviously, you don't want to use them in melee. You want to shoot with them. So I find it fairly difficult to use them. What the f- oh, that's my, I was gonna say, what the fuck are they doing over there? There they are, on that hill. Okay. So we'll start, actually, let's get all of our men in there. You guys are strong enough. Just for units, right? Yeah. Okay. And the reason I attack with these guys, I get less experience. Is he actually moving towards me? No, it doesn't look like he's moving back further on the hill. Reason I attack with this guy, I get less experience from my general, but I potentially get a second general, or an extra general, because this guy already won a fight just now. So it's funny, because he's the actual general in this fight, rather than an actual general. Anyway, what was I talking about? Guns are hard to use. But yeah, the four Thunderbusts, two generals, obviously, as always. That's, say, six or eight. What do you call those guys? Actually, no, it's not going to be eight. It's going to be six guns, I think. Six guns, four Thunderbusts. No, that also doesn't work. It's going to be two Thunderbusts, I think. I'm not entirely sure yet. I have to think about this. The thing I want is I want either eight Katana Cav or four Katana Cav, four Naginata, or six Katana and two Naginata. I need some heavy infantry because I'm going to be lacking infantry because I have a lot of guns. So that's my thought process behind that. Okay, I think the best approach is just to spread out really wide and just go on. Oh, we're actually all here, aren't we? Or no, we're still waiting for those two bozos who are losing morale. But yeah, so I want eight heavy infantry units, or eight infantry units, and a few of them heavy. Which means sacrificing either some Thunderbusts or some Portuguese Tercos. Oh, they're moving further back on the hill. That's actually pretty good for me. The slope gets... Oh, now they're moving forward again. Never mind. They are going to be stopping right there. Well, alright then. I think it's time that we initiate the attack. I want it to be fairly wide. I'll walk for now. Keep these guys close, although I really doubt they're going to make any impact on this fight. And keep you as a last resort. And general. She may as well. No, I want you in range. Let's put these guys a little bit closer. Actually, just move you over here. We're also hidden with everything except for these two bozos. Alright, we're in range. Let's start running at them. Actually, I'll go into loose formation for a little bit as well. Alright. It is on.
Hidden units, my lord.
Treacherously meant to ambush us. Oh yeah, I'm sure they were treacherously meant to ambush us. No Yari wall for me this time around. Looks like they actually really don't have the Yaris to hold up. Actually, these guys may as well go into Yari wall. Oh, nearly got poked by them. Since we have larger units. Let's actually send you this way instead. Now you can go in there. Alright, general. Get your ass in closer. Inspire dish units. Alright. Yeah, we'll just try and run these guys around. I really don't think it's going to make any difference, though. Let's have you guys shoot their archers for whatever reason. Okay, you're still killing this unit. Not sure why you're making that weird formation that you're doing right now. Let's actually charge you through. Alright, we're done there, done there, and okay. General, you have a field day for me. Oh, they might actually start shooting. Charge them, not them, because I might shoot them. Go on, shoot some of them. Go on. Yeah. Yeah, we're killing some of them. Look at that. Like six kills. Well done. Yep, it was six as well. Alright, that was good. I mean, I wasn't really expecting anything bad from that. It was just, yeah, we had to attack them. I couldn't defend on that one. And that should be this army gone. Hopefully. can't really attack them anymore because I have to make sure I get back into my town. Alright, that unit should be gone. We only really managed to kill one unit, although we ran through some other units as well on the way, so we killed 128. Okay, I think there's much. Oh, oh, there you go. Much else we can do, I was gonna say. Man, this is. How many fights so far? Like three? This episode? Pretty good. It's definitely a really interesting start for this campaign. It's pretty crazy. But a lot of fun. I really like the Otomo. They're one of my favorite clans. Just, well, any clan that's really different from the rest is fun. That's why I don't like the Mori too much. They're just the average clan. The only thing they've got going for them is different navy. But I hate navy, so, you know. Same with Tokugawa. They have no special units or anything. Except for the Mounted Gunner. But that's from an actual DLC. They don't have any, like, they're just... You just use katanas on them. Or, sorry, you just, they're still alive as well. But that's too little to care, I don't think. Or I think, even... Let's get in with these guys, get into... There we go. Alright, so we made it. I don't think I want to do that. Just gonna need to level up at some point, though. Tsukushi should be able to defend against that. What is this? One archer? Yeah, that's fine. I just hope they don't go for my farms or whatever. That would be more annoying, really. So Tsukushi is at minus 7, which when these guys die, it'll be happier. Heizen is actually happy right now. But that's because I have so many units in here, of course. Boozen is on 1, and it has a unit in there as well. Which I may as well send to Tsukushi. Already moved my ships. Two units here that I was going to keep as well in case the Ito for some reason decide to declare war on me. I feel like they should easily be able to take this town, the Ito, because the Shimazu have got their main army over here. It's got two generals in it at least, so I assume that's both their generals. I don't remember my Shimazu campaign that well, so I don't remember what their generals look like, but... also, if you're wondering whether I'm going to make my cavalry here, I don't think I will, unless I decide to have two Yari Cav, which is a possibility that I've been thinking about. I might do, but... My Dunderbuss will definitely be made here, because obviously I get the extra accuracy. Accuracy! Okay, so let's, you're going over there? Wait, what? No, you were going over there, and this guy was going over there. Yeah, okay. Anyway, I think I'm going to end the turn. I can't make any more units. Do we have enough money to queue up one more? Yep, we do, may as well. Might cancel it again next turn, I don't know. And now there might be another attack from the rebels. But we'll see. And I will end it on that if that's the case. Because I'm running out of time. But our day might not reach. These guys are going to reach. That's fine. I'm going to just auto-resolve that, I think. Didn't get an extra general, by the way, which is too bad. Although I think that's because we didn't have the money. I didn't actually think about that, but you need $1,000 to get that option. How did that unit just get in there? Alright, they didn't actually make it. It's good. Alright, we're not going to go for Essence of the Spirit. We're going to go for... Yeah, we need money. Before anything else. Ship build, clan destroy, Decono. And construction complete. Bunch of buildings. Right, so now we are going to make a Matsuke right away. In Tsukushi. Which will give us a rank 3 Matsuke. I'm not going to do that right now because we don't have... the time. I wonder how this happened. This unit just randomly walked in there after that fight. I don't know what happened there. Okay, so this is another easy one. Especially since this army is quite large, actually. And it's probably only going to have, yeah, 2 or 3 archers. Probably 2. It's probably going to be similar to this army over here. And we also still don't have any unhappiness. And this place, you can actually see now, is +1 because of the military crackdown. Although this is still going to go up while this goes down. So... we're going to still run into problems. But hey, eventually they will all be happy. We need to get some more missionaries as well. Some may want to make like a chapel somewhere, like here or something. We've got one. Actually, we don't have any, do we? I don't know. This is not going to be a province where I'm going to build anything. So a chapel would be useful here. Plus, it'll start changing these provinces too. I think it actually. Yes, yeah, spreads. Wow, that's really good. 1.5 right away. So that's definitely something I'm going to do. I might make one No, I can't make one there. And I'm not going to make one here either. I might make one here as well. But then it's kind of useless. Well, I guess that would still work. This is not bordering Heezen, though. So Heezen's going to take a long time before it changes. Anyway, I'm going to end the episode here. It's going to be that for now. So thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and I shall see you next time. Have a good day. Bye-bye.